to the program that takes you on an adventure through the sights and sounds of Korea. This is Travel Story, and I'm Jesse Day.
Hello, everyone. I'm Sammy, and today we have a very special guest joining us in our studio. Please welcome the drummer for Korean indie band, D. Anthony Nelson Jr. Hello, D.
Welcome.
Hello, my name is D. Anthony Nelson Jr. I am from the United States of America, and I am the drummer for the Korean rock band, Cyborg.
Well, D, the name of your group sounds so interesting, Cyborg. Does it have any meaning to it? What kind of music do you guys play?
We are a indie math pop rock band.
Mm-hmm.
And we have like electronics and guitar and drums, and there's a lot of different things going on, and we try to experiment with various sounds, and it's very interesting here in Korea.
Well, as you may have gathered from our special guest today, today's theme is a musical journey to friendship.
That's right, and music connects all people around the world, regardless of the age, nationality, and language. And I know we will be meeting this Belgian singer named Sion today. Have you heard of the singer-songwriter Sion?
Yes, I have heard of Sion. He's been a while for quite a long time now. And I do like the way that he plays his music, and mm-hmm. he tries to connect with the audience. He uses very good chord structures, but his lyrics, I think they have very good meaning. That's something that everybody can connect with.
Well, Sion is actually a famous singer-songwriter in Belgium, and he has a very special passion for Korea. So why don't we meet him now?
One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four.
Okay, here we go. This is my music video. My name is Frederick Sion, and I'm a singer. Since I debuted in Belgium over 10 years ago, I've released 5 albums and performed in many different countries. For a little over a year now, I've been trying to make it in Korea.
안녕하세요. I'm Sion. I'm from Belgium. It's my 4th time in Korea, and I'm really looking forward for this collaboration with Thirdland Butterfly and this trip. My 4th time here feels like home already.
Korea is the home of K-pop, a genre that's sweeping over the world. There's such a variety of music here, and a tremendous number of music lovers. And among them are my fans. I'm going to sing for them, together with Third Line Butterfly, one of Korea's most recognized modern rock bands. Third Line Butterfly and Sion. Come along and hear our music.
More than 10 years after his debut, Sion began a new project, traveling the world in search of music. And for a little over a year now, Sion has been performing in Korea.
That's right. And he recently met up with one of the more popular Korea indie rock bands called Third Line Butterfly.
That's right.
D, have you ever performed with Third Line Butterfly before?
I haven't personally performed with them, but the band has. I've heard that they're really, really good. And I've listened to some of their music as well.
Dee, I know that you've worked with a Korean pop singer, Seo In-young, and you were on stage with her. And you've also worked with so many different kinds of great artists so far. Tell us about your experiences.
With Seo In-young, it was very, very great experience and opportunity. I had a lot of fun. And I think that everybody else who was there working on that project, they mm-hmm. also had a lot of fun too.
Were you nervous by any chance?
I wasn't too nervous, but I knew that when I was there with other people who knew what they wanted to do and why they were there. So mm-hmm. I felt comfortable with that.
Yeah, and I think it's more easy to connect with other musicians as well. And Sion decided to go on a trip with one of the members of Third Line Butterfly to further strengthen their musical connection. So let's follow along on their journey.
One, two, three, four.
Bukchon Hanok Village, Seoul. The alleys are lined with traditional houses that embody the beauty of Korea. I've always wanted to come here, and today I'm here with the vocalist of Third Line Butterfly, Sangha. we decided to spend some time together ahead of our collaboration.
So, I mean, not like other area, we have kind of old traditional town, but they are empty there. But here, the people live here.
No. 진짜?
Yeah.
Nice. If I come to live in Seoul, I will stay here.
Maybe you can rent a place here. I hear...
집, 집에서.
Yeah.
집.
집에서.
For the past decade, we've been doing our own music on opposite sides of the world. Naturally, we need time to get to know each other.
감사합니다.
네, 안녕하십시오. 아, 네. 안녕히 가십시오.
안녕히 계세요.
수고하세요.
Just as we are walking side by side now, we must work in tune with each other as music partners.
We're here in the neighborhood of a shop called Kakao Boom, and the owner of the place is called Yongju Go. She's a friend I met through another friend in Belgium. And when I come to South Korea, I always stay with her, but we're gonna give her a short visit, and we're gonna eat some chocolate. 맛있어요.
I want to introduce Sangha to my friend. You can tell a person by his or her friends. I know Sangha and my friend will get along just fine.
Well, I think nice people should meet each other the most of all. So if I can introduce two very nice people to each other, then it makes me a very happy person.
Connected to the alleys of the Hanok village is Samcheongdong. This is one of the prettiest neighborhoods in Seoul, with age-old Hanok standing alongside little shops. It feels almost like my hometown because my friend lives here.
She sang with Stella, she sang with Miriam Akeba, did a tour, but she also worked on my project. And she's such a nice person, and I still call her my second mom, in fact. And so sometimes you meet these people, and from the first moment I met Yongju in Belgium, I knew this was going to be a lifetime friend. You can feel it.
I opened up to Sangha for the first time, and she listened, as if listening to my music on stage. It's always nice to walk with a friend, and to be on the way to meet another friend.
So, but he was not ready for kids. I mean, in those days, it was something that you do.
Here, this is where my friend is. Yongju is a chocolatier specializing in traditional Belgian handmade chocolates. I have her chocolates whenever I'm in Korea. Not only are they delicious, but they fill me to the soul.
Kakaboom. Kakaboom.
To me, Korea is as sweet as Yongju's chocolate. Korea loved my music before it knew my name or my face. That experience was as strong as the rich taste of chocolate.
Sometimes we go to 2 hours. Well, I came to Korea because I had fans. I had looked on the, when I was on Twitter, I saw that people were listening to my song Cruisin' because it was used for the commercial of Bimpol clothing. And I thought, oh, this should be the moment to go there to meet the fans, because it's actually thanks to them, because they were listening to my music, they were posting it on Facebook and Twitter. When are you coming to Korea? So I took a moment to look for some contacts and send some emails. And I was fortunate to have some contacts at Chile Music, for instance, to release my album here.
Youngju is my biggest supporter when I'm performing in Korea. I'm sure Sangha has felt her support as well. Opening up to each other created a new bridge between me and my musical partner. All we have to do is cross that bridge, step by step. There's another story I want to tell Sangha, and it's found here. One of the most famous college districts in Korea, the Street of Youth, Shincheon. I came here a year ago.
We're going to the record shop where I went in November.
So this is the record shop?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, that's your poster here.
Yeah.
Did you like visiting record shops?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I really enjoy visiting record shops.
Because nowadays a lot of people listen to sound sources on internet.
Yeah. Yeah. It's turning to more of a digital thing, but there's something nice about having the album in your hands with
right.
the inside cover and stuff like that.
Yeah, it's a little bit more personal. You can make more contact with the artist that way.
Sure.
Do you know this guy?
No.
And this he's he's great. He's kind of indie, but because not many people, it's not popular, but not like Serge Gainsbourg, but for all the musicians, he's like an idol. He's great.
Yes.
You should check out sometime. He's a very good singer-songwriter.
It's a huge box.
Yeah. That.
Discovering new music is a thrilling experience for any musician. That's why I always go to a record store on my travels. To communicate with people through music, you must first understand the music of their country. It was in a record store that I found a way to reach Korean fans a year ago. I found a Korean label I liked and called them to propose a new album. A year later, that album came out. I don't know where I found the courage. But I'm glad I did, because I got to meet Korean fans.
Well, I know now, it's the fourth time that I came here. But I've noticed on Twitter that people were listening. They were saying that I had to come here. When are you coming to Korea? So I took the chance to do it. But I didn't expect that the song Cruisin' was that well known. I really didn't expect it, because when I take a plane, it takes more than 11 hours to come here. So on the other side of the world, it's just a great and refreshing thing to experience.
I like Korean music as much as Koreans like mine. K-pop is very popular in Europe, and I particularly like Korea's indie scene. Sangha introduced me to an amazing album.
Thank you so much.
There's another reason this street is special for me. After my first concert in Korea last year, I gave many performances, small and large. Being a rookie singer in Korea, everything was a surprise. Korean indie music was as well made as K-pop, and the fans were so enthusiastic. There are even K-indie fans in Europe now. And this was where it all began. My first stage in Korea. I'm back at the starting line with my new music partner. The memories come rushing back.
If you do an acoustic tour,
I remember the unfamiliarity before the concert and the heat after it. The people in the audience. And me on stage. It was our first encounter, but we became one through music.
So there was a grand piano there?
Yeah.
A big one. Not the white one, nice. Like Elton John. No. Black. One. Yeah, good.
Better.
And yeah, just I didn't mean what to expect. The sound was very well.
Yeah.
And people went bananas.
Yeah, they loved you. They adore you.
Aww. When I played Cruise, and it was like, oh, no. Yes.
Oh.
I said, these Korean fans, they are the best.
Yeah.
You are very lucky to have those fans. Such
yeah,
fans.
I am. So, sometimes, yeah, I'm surprised how people like, and I was like, oh, like, I'm moved. Like,
yes. Yeah, that's the word.
Yes.
Yeah, we can be very moved.
Yes.
By the fans.
Shincheon is where I had my first concert in Korea, and where Sangha had hers. It's amazing that we have a memory in common when for most of our lives we were half a world away from each other. I want to tell her how I felt here on this small stage a year ago. But a song is worth 1,000 words.
If I want to paint the White House red, why shouldn't I do it? My trip to Korea, for me, it's really magical. You have to know that Cruisin', I wrote that song maybe in 2002. This is 11 years ago. It's the song that made me popular in Belgium. It's the song that now made me popular in Korea. And I also knew that when my song was used for the commercial in 2006, I felt that because of the fans, I really had to do this trip now, before it was too late, before they maybe had forgotten about me. And the fact that I'm coming here now for the fourth time in less than a year, I mean, it's really a special thing to experience, not only as a musician, but also as a person. It's really a personal life experience, and I thank you all, the fans, for that. Climb up a mountain then go back down. Why shouldn't I do it? I get a big feeling.
The musical journey that began on this stage is still in progress.
I can't hold it in, I gotta scream it out. Why shouldn't I love you? Shouldn't I love you?
Ah. Cute song. Wow.
Samnida. Why shouldn't I play in Korea?
It's the day of my concert with Third Line Butterfly. People's eyes and ears are drawn to the performance we've created together over the past few days.
I like that time before the show, before it starts.
The anticipation.
Yeah.
Do you get the adrenaline rush?
Yeah, you get that feeling, you know, it's like, hey, I'm about to...
Butterflies in your stomach?
There's a butterfly right there.
A third line butterfly.
Yeah.
Everything is perfect. Our instrumentals, Sangha's voice, and the people listening to our music. I'll never forget my music life in Korea, and this performance will also stay with me for the rest of my life.
Wow, I love the energy that Third Line Butterfly and Seon are creating on stage. And I'm sure it was a lot of fun for Korean fans to enjoy Seon's music in person, finally. And I hear that there are a lot of fans that are tuning into K-indie music all around the world.
Yeah, well, actually, Korea's indie music scene is getting more and more interesting with people collaborating and fusing different music styles, everything from jazz and DJing together. Dee, how would you evaluate the indie music scene in Korea?
I would say that the indie music scene in Korea is steadily growing. I think that it started about 20 years ago, but it's been steadily rising, and the demand will continue to grow. You know, if you know the fans, they participate, you know, in the concerts, and you know, they get on Twitter, you know, at the concert, you know, they see, oh, it's an amazing, really great show. And then, you know, they should say something. Hey, you know, Third Line Butterfly, Seon, they did an amazing job.
Right. I think people do have to dig a little bit deeper than, say, with K-pop, which has gone international. I myself am a big fan of K-pop music. I'm known as a K-pop encyclopedia amongst my friends. But I would like to learn more about the K-indie scene. And if you'd like to learn more about it, too, then check out today's travel tip.
To experience the energy of Korean indie music, the first thing you must do is to visit music festivals. Heat up your summers with the Incheon Pinafore Rock Festival, as well as the Valley Rock Festival and Supersonic in Ansan and Jisan. In the autumn, you will find the Grand Mint Festival and Hongdae Zandari Festa. Also, don't miss out on the Seoul Fringe Festival or Mukon Seoul, a festival designed to raise the reputation of Korean pop music. If you're looking for a musical experience on a smaller, everyday scale, there's no place better than the Hongdae area to enjoy Korean indie music. The Hongdae area refers to the streets in front of the main gate to Hongik University. In the early 1990s, the area became a hotbed for live music clubs fostering underground culture. That culture lives on today, and you can see indie bands performing in Hongdae's live clubs or even on the streets. On the last Friday of every month, there's also an event called Club Day, when you can freely move between live clubs for the price of one. Hongdae is already a famous destination for young tourists from all around the world. You should definitely check it out.
Well, I myself have been to Hongdae a lot. In fact, I've performed there a few times as a rapper. Mm. So I've got a bit of an idea of the music scene happening there. Dee, I'm sure you've performed there before. What are some of your most memorable memories about those times?
I've played in Hongdae quite a few times, and every time was very memorable. And I would say one time we played with No Age, their international band, and we played with them, and the crowd was really, really nice that night. And I remember one guy from No Age, he wrapped himself in toilet paper.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, I don't know what he was doing, but wow, everybody loved it.
That experimental indie flair, right?
Oh, yeah. He almost caught on fire.
I think fans are acting as like vitamins for musicians, because without fans, it's almost impossible for you to be on stage. I mean, you get the energy from them. I mean, playing on stage, it's very physically challenging. How do you keep yourself inspired, and how do you stay fit?
I would say I stay fit because I play the drums.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, really, really busy. Uh-huh. And I do sweat a lot. Don't come smell me.
After a show, yeah.
After a show, no. But, you know, it is very demanding, and it does tire my body, because sometimes I carry my gear with me, my own snare and cymbals and stuff like that. And I would say just the reaction of the fans and their energy given back to me. You know, it's like if I give it, they give it back, I give them more.
Now, Seon and his companion from Third Line Butterfly are going to go on a musical journey together to get inspiration for their new song. So let's head to Chuncheon with them and see what happens.
This is a train station where people gather and then part as they go their own ways. Some head to the mountains, some to the beach, to make a special experience for themselves.
Staring back through the window, bending over.
On the sixth day of my stay in Korea, I also went to the train station. I'll be taking off on a special journey. My music partner and I will be seeking out new harmonies on this trip and inspiration for a new song. Our destination is Chuncheon. Apparently, it's a popular destination for rail trips in Korea. And our musical journey, with my guitar too, begins here. The train heads to Chuncheon, loaded with the marvel of a new journey.
그렇게 친해질 기회는 별로 없었거든요. 그래서 이번에 여행하면서 24시간 계속 붙어 있을 테니까 잘 때 빼고 더 많이 좀 이렇게 같이 작업을 하기 전에 좀 사람 알아가는 기회가 될 것 같고요.
안녕하세요.
And here is, of course, the traditional train snack. I think I know what's coming.
It's like a rolling
stone. Eggs? Eggs, yes. Cracked on the head for good measure. You got
it. That's right.
Let's see if they do that. He's thinking about it.
Right there.
I didn't do it, though. You got to do it.
But he tried it.
He thought about it. He considered.
He almost did.
He almost did.
Four tangerines.
Tangerines, yes. Like train food.
Yeah, exactly.
Brown eggs. I admit I was taken off guard.
Special egg.
Never tried this. Huh? It's a grilled oven baked.
Oh no, I never saw it before.
It's very good.
Cool.
You'll like it.
Turns out that brown eggs are quite chewy and tasty.
You like?
Mm-hmm. 좋다. 좋아, 좋아요.
This is my first time traveling with Sangha. We don't do anything special, but it feels good just to share snacks and good music, like a good sign for what's to come.
I think also that is a part of the collaboration, or the, certainly when you work with people from a different culture, you certainly have to know the little bit of the history of the country or the people, but also to see different places. Now I know my way in Hongdae and Seoul, but it's good to know what where the core of the country is at, and how people are feeling there, and how they behave, how they live. And really looking forward to expect to have a lot of input on that side. Inspiration. That's it.
In no time, the train rolls into Chuncheon Station. So what's waiting for us here? Chuncheon boasts a beautiful river and lake, which even gave it the nickname City of the Lake. It's a famous destination for couples for its romantic atmosphere. And since 30 to 40 years ago, it's been the number one travel destination for college students to visit with their friends. It's also a city of music, once hosting a major music competition for college students. Over time, it became an important gateway that gave amateur musicians a chance to make their debut. Not surprisingly, the city rings with stories of music. The city center is wrapped around by Soyang River, which became famous through a song titled after its name.
The lyrics of the song we just heard?
Yeah. So I just read that There's this singer-songwriter, Kanye West. Mm-hmm. And he visited Chuncheon to write songs. And he met this girl. And he told her that I'll write a song for you. And then when the record comes out, I'll like come here and give it to you. And everything like, it's been like, it's quite famous song. Even I know it. So.
The song was such a hit that there's even a statue dedicated to it. Creating good music is a lifelong mission for all composers.
Ooh, that's where I get my musical inspiration from. It's a difficult question, but it has a very simple answer. I try to make music in the most honest way as possible, and I'm writing about how I feel. I'm writing about my environment, about my friends, about what's happening in the world sometimes, but always about things that are very close around me, not about artificial things or things that do not exist. I try to make music and write lyrics just as honest as how I feel.
I have a feeling that I'll find myself singing about this day in the future.
Well, the connection was good.
Next, we headed to a famous street in Chuncheon.
Finally.
All of the shops crowding this alley sell the same food, dak galbi, which has become a symbol of the city. Chicken is seasoned with spicy sauce and grilled on a hot plate. You have to try it to really experience Chuncheon.
Smells good. Can you tell me what is?
네, 노란 노란 사서. 아, 이걸 이렇게 고기랑 이렇게.
하나 드세요.
아니 안 익어서 조금 더 있거든.
아 이거.
그래서 이렇게 사서.
Wrap it up and then eat. 감사합니다.
잘 먹을게요.
Actually, there's a bigger story to it. My girlfriend is Korean. She's adopted in Belgium when she was 4 years old, and she is into the Korean cuisine, and she imported the tables, so we have 15 tables at home. So she is doing the Korean catering and the mokja in Ghent, my town. So I eat kimchi very often.
I'm a huge fan of Korean food, especially all kinds of kimchi and bulgogi. I'm busy promoting it to my Belgian friends, who are still a little hesitant. But they'll love it in no time.
How do you spell it?
Yeah.
Okay, let's eat.
Woohoo!
Yeah.
Attack!
잘 먹겠습니다.
맛있게 드세요.
It's my first time trying it, but I like it. Now I have one more thing to introduce to my friends back home. But first, I figured I could start by telling foreigners in Korea.
좋아요. 맛있게 드세요.
Good music and good food. The memories we make on this trip will bring us that much closer to each other.
Having again my favorite dream.
As befits a city of music, a lot of amateur indie musicians are based here. Sanga and I sought out their hideout.
From the hood, you know.
Right, so this is the place that they gather, the musicians gather, indie musicians here gather. So let's check it out. Yeah, in Chuncheon.
I'm looking forward to meeting these young people who are all about indie music.
안녕하세요.
I always enjoy meeting other musicians.
Don't stop, play.
Indie music is the most popular genre in Belgium, but here in Chuncheon, it's losing its ground. To these musicians, even this small stage is a gift. The performance is humble, but it shines with their passion for music.
Yeah, of course, yeah. It reminds me to see them working on new songs and do some tryouts. And I think it was a great period when I started out. Everything was so fresh. Everything was so spontaneous. You are very naive in the beginning, and that's a good feeling. It's a good sentiment to work on your music.
Listening to their pure, unpretentious melodies reminds me of my younger days. There was a time when I was just like them. We speak different languages, but communicate through music.
Well, good job. Mm. Very nice song. Catchy. Catchy.
Catchy.
Yeah.
Really?
Very catchy.
Yeah.
Radio.
Oh, thank you. Okay, ready?
1, 2, 3.
When there's music, our differences in language and background don't matter.
Life.
We start impromptu, but with each passing note, we create our own harmonies. When we create chords, it feels as if rays of light are shining through the room, as if the notes are alive.
Staring right through the window, bending over to me, sentimental forsaken. It's always great. From the first moment when I came in, I just wanted to play, and I just wanted to meet with them on a musical level and see what they got to say. And I think jamming like this should happen more often. I miss it sometimes as well. Kamsahamnida, Jangmal Kamsahamnida, for the music and the invitation here. I wish you guys all the best. And, really, Chuncheon's got talent.
프로는 다르구나. 저희가 갈 길이 얼마나 이런 생각이 들었습니다. 열심히 준비해서 그 뒤를 좀 따라가고 싶습니다. 오늘 너무 감사했어요. 오.
All I can do for them as a musician with a bit more stage experience is support their music.
네.
I hope that my support will give them strength. Our musical journey in Chuncheon is not over yet.
That's the famous Nami Island. Have you ever been there?
Nami Island? I don't believe I have. What's it all about?
You take the boat like that,
yeah,
and get to the island, and there is this immigration part where you have to go through immigration.
Oh, really?
They call it immigration because you have to take the boat to get to the island.
Okay.
So that's the whole fun for it.
Right.
You
know?
We are merely crossing a river, but it almost feels as if we are heading to a strange new world. And just 5 minutes later, we arrived on Nami Island. The island is designed like a natural theme park. Everything I see is inspiration for my music. Every moment of my trip matters. Nami Island, full of lush green trees and delicate flowers, has strikingly beautiful sights. Just walking down the tree-lined paths will make the trip worthwhile. So we decided to give ourselves over to nature and just walk. The sound of birds, the wind, and the rain create a beautiful, natural melody. And the melody takes us, so fittingly, to the Song Museum.
Park Soo-chun, he's a songwriter in early 20th century. So, yeah, 100-year anniversary.
Great.
So he wrote many, many songs, and like 100 singers sang his song.
Wow. Fantastic.
There are like his handwriting or, you know, the things.
Inside, an exhibition is paying tribute to a giant of Korean pop music. He was from a different time, but his music will always remain with the Korean people.
I like these old covers.
Oh, that's great.
Imagine to have a cover like this. Beautiful.
I wonder.
The history of Korean pop music makes me feel the power of K-pop. I hope that Sangha's music will play here someday. We make a promise to return here together then. As singer-songwriters, we can't help but be intrigued by folk instruments from around the world. Of course, the Korean instruments grab my attention the most.
Gayageum. And that's geomugo.
It's the same method where you...
No, normally you play geomugo with the stick like that. You how do you say? To pick the strings with the stick.
And this is with your hands.
Yeah, with your hand. You do it with the...
Ding, 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 ding.
So it sounds a little bit different. That's more delicate, and that's more like masculine kind. I saw them play really like up close, and it sounds really great if you really hear it from the up close.
It's a beautiful instrument. Mm. Beautiful.
Traditional Korean instruments have a unique sound. If I have the chance, I want to write a song just for Korean instruments.
Yeah, definitely. Actually, when I was doing a project in South Africa, I also bought a lot of instruments from the African scene, so I hope to maybe buy some of the Korean traditional instruments. I think we are used to sounds like the piano, guitar, bass, violin, like classical instruments, but these instruments have a totally different sound. So it's very interesting. I also use some of those instruments even in my pop music.
Nothing is impossible in music. Maybe that's why I've chosen this life. A day packed with music comes to a close in Chuncheon. What we saw through this trip is hope for our ongoing musical journey. And we've become more passionate about working together. We are confident that together we'll be able to give the best performances in Korea and in Belgium.
네.
네.
예.
먹자.
잘 먹겠습니다.
try it out. It's the, like, remember I told you about the grilled?
Grilled rice.
Mm.
It's pressed rice.
Yes, it's pressed.
We still have a lot to learn about each other, which is why our journey doesn't stop here.
Exquisite.
In Korea, people say that getting started is half the work. I guess we've already come halfway. Now, we just have halfway left to go. And she and I are communicating in perfect sync through music.
Yeah, the trip was just great. I had a wonderful time. It was good to getting to know Sana a little bit better. It's good for the collaboration that we're going to do. Like I said, music is one thing, but if you know each other in a better way, that helps the music and the communication in the rehearsal room as well. And the trip, yeah, we had a wonderful time. We ate a lot of great stuff. We had a good time. We left. We saw Chuncheon. We saw the statue. We went to the museum. It was just marvelous. Yeah. I had a splendid time. Thank you.
I'm wandering the world on a boat called music. My music brought me to Korea, and I met people who welcomed me. And now I sing with them. My musical journey in Korea is just beginning.
I love how Sion and Sanga are making music together. Their friendship becomes a lot stronger through, you know, communicating through music.
Definitely.
And Chuncheon is a very nostalgic place for Koreans in their 30s and 40s because they used to hop on a train to just spend some weekends over there. And even nowadays, college students, they make a day trip or they even go to camping over there.
Right.
Have you ever been to Chuncheon D?
Yes, I have been to Chuncheon. I've played a festival there. It's called the Chuncheon Mine Festival,
mm-hmm.
and it was very, very nice. And also, I saw some bands playing traditional instruments there as well, like incorporated into indie rock. And Chuncheon is a very, very nice place to go for traveling or to see a concert. You know, it's a very, very nice place. I had a great time there.
Well, we hope that Sion's career in Korea and Third Line Butterfly's career in Belgium will be both successful, and yours too, Dee.
Absolutely.
And before we say goodbye, do you have any last advice to foreign tourists visiting Korea?
I would say that, you know, you should come down and to Korea and have a very, very great time. The people are very nice, and there's lots of great food, as we saw.
Right.
Yeah, I'm hungry. lots of great food and just great people, and, you know, there's music here, too.
Yeah.
There's definitely good music here in Korea.
And is there any specific areas you could maybe direct music fans to who are coming to Korea and who want to check out the indie scene?
There's a really big indie scene in Hongdae and Sincheon, and also just recently, even Mule is starting to become more artsy now these
days.
Yeah, and just many different places here in Seoul.
yeah, get out there and see a show.
Yeah.
And we all know about K-pop, which has swept the world, but if you dig a little bit deeper, you'll be able to hear the sweet sounds of Korean indie music. That's all the time we have today on Travel Story. Have a great day.
See you next time. Bye.
Bye.